As one of the worst droughts in the state's history drags on, Californians will decide on Proposition 1. If passed, the measure would authorize more than $7 billion in new bonds to pay for projects ranging from new reservoirs to watershed protection and water recycling. Supporters say the proposition is needed to boost and protect the state's water supply. Critics worry about the impact of building new dams and question how the measure would provide drought relief. Joining me with analysis is Ellen Hanick, a senior fellow at the Public Policy Institute of California, a nonpartisan think tank based in San Francisco. Welcome to the program, Ellen.
Thank you.
Well, as we said, Prop 1 would authorize $7.5 billion in bonds for water-related projects. How would that money be used specifically?
So a big chunk of it would go toward water supply projects. About half, I think we calculated, and a large component would be for storage projects. And that can be both surface storage, so new reservoirs, and also for groundwater storage, which means projects to help you store water underground in aquifers.
And about $1.5 billion for watershed protection and restoration as well?
That's right. And then there's funding for different kinds of local projects, supporting things like recycling, potentially desalination, conservation, different types of support for conservancies, habitat, a big mix.
But by far the biggest chunk would go for water storage projects, dams and the such. And that is also the most controversial part of this bond.
That's correct.
But what is the challenge of building new dams, and why so much controversy over it?
So the controversy is really about using state dollars, state taxpayer dollars, for building new dams. In fact, over the last few decades, we have built at the local level some new reservoirs. Both here in the Bay Area, we built the Los Vaqueros Reservoir, that's in Contra Costa County, and down in Southern California, they built Diamond Valley Lake. Those are projects that are funded locally for urban water supply systems so that they can, to help them get through droughts like this. The controversy is about putting taxpayer dollars into large projects that would be used for the State Water Project, the Central Valley Project, supporting agriculture as well as cities.
You've focused on water issues for a long time. How do Californians get their water? We take it for granted, but it's a rather complicated system.
It is, and the answer to that really depends on exactly where you live. So if you live here in San Francisco, where we're sitting now, your water actually comes from Yosemite National Park, and it travels a long way to get here. If you're living in the East Bay, your water comes from further up in that watershed, but also up in the Sierras. And if you live in Santa Clara Valley, your water probably comes from Northern California and it makes its way through the Delta before it gets to you.
And so then, and agriculture actually uses 80% of the water. So what we've talked about is residential usage, but agriculture eats up a lot of it.
It does. Well, agriculture in California, California is the biggest agricultural state in the country. We are, you know, fantastic producers of fruits and vegetables and nuts and all kinds of things. We have really good soils, we have great sunshine, but in order to produce agriculture here, you really do need to add water because the summer is dry.
So we've got a lot of water demand. Why do supporters think this water bond is needed, and why do opponents not want it?
So I would say there are more supporters than opponents at this point, because this was a bond that was put on the ballot by the legislature and it passed with very strong bipartisan support. So you have really support at the political leadership level from both parties. You have support from a lot of the groups that care about water sort of at the state and national level, including environmental groups and water agencies and so on, cities and counties. The opposition is coming more from some smaller environmental groups and some sports fishing groups and some folks in the Delta who are concerned, I think, about the amount of money that's available for storage. And I think folks in the Delta are also concerned about whether there's any way in which that could help make the Governor's Tunnel projects more likely.
Does this bond affect the Delta?
The bond has a little bit of money for the Delta. It has much less money than what a previous bond proposal had. So I think it's about $135 million for the Delta ecosystem. So that's a small share of the total. The bond also has money for Delta levies to support the agricultural activities there. But most of the money is really for other things.
The state hasn't built any new dams in more than 30 years. What kind of impact do you think the new dams would have on our water supply compared to other efforts like, for example, water conservation? Does it make sense to pour so much money into dams?
So, you know, back up maybe and just keep track of sort of where we've been putting state money. In the 2000s, between 2000 and 2006, voters approved almost $20 billion for water bonds, and none of that money went to storage. A lot of that money went to the ecosystem and watersheds, but a lot also went to projects like conservation, recycling, various ways to stretch available supplies and to add to new supplies. So this bond has more for water supply than some of those earlier ones, but it's really kind of continuing on with more for some of these more local projects. The new thing is that it does also have money for storage. And water experts look at this and typically think that you need a mix. There's no silver bullet, really, in terms of the options.
Will Prop 1 do anything, though, to ease the impact of the current drought?
No. And that's because it takes time to build these new projects and undertake these investments.
So nothing immediate to ease what we're seeing now in the state, but certainly a long-term remedy if it is approved by voters in the fall.
It could help us get ready for the next drought.
All right, Ellen, thank you. Ellen Hennick is with the Public Policy Institute of California.